coming?
Come on, Gav. I'm just How you doing? Nice credit.
I almost didn't recognize you there because I used to watch you from when you used to be a fighter. And how's life treating you now?
Yeah, it's good, aye. Supposed to be retired and busy and ever, but life's good. Boxing's my passion and my life, so everything's okay.
So tell me more about this Cody Davies. What could we expect from him in this fight?
Obviously a clinic boxing display. What I really believe is you box his ass off for the first six rounds and you'll start stopping him on later rounds, between 8 and 9.
Could we explain the stoppage? Who could we add the champion here as well? Coming champ. Sam, I think we've had enough of you, thank you.
Yeah, I'm done.
You talk enough shit.
You're right.
Really nice things about you. Delete that out.
How you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good, thank you, all good.
So you're not struggling to make this weight then, are you?
No, mate, with ease. We take my diet and my nutrition very seriously. We've planned the weight cut weeks in advance, so yeah, it's all coming down, all feeling good.
You feel it's a mistake for Zachary to take this fight with you?
I wouldn't say it's a mistake. Actually, I admire him for taking it and giving us a chance to be able to have a fight with an undefeated fighter and put it all on the line. That's what we want. So yeah, credit to him. Let's have it.
Because a lot of people give you the rating because of your amateur pedigree, but in the last couple of months, we've seen a couple of top amateurs like what's this guy's name? The Cuban just got a debut. He won 2 gold medals and he lost on his debut. Do you still want to take your pedigree as an advantage while you feel you're ahead?
I've never took my pedigree as an advantage. You know, people with my amateur pedigree normally turn pro with a big promoter, and you know they have a nice little route up through. I turn pro with no promoter. I had a message off Sam. He set us up with a meeting up in London, and one thing led to another. I started out as if I had no amateur pedigree, but yeah. You know, fights like this now, times like this, is all going to come into play, and you'll see the difference on Saturday night.
So what weight do you really want to campaign at? Is it going to be...
Super middleweight. I'm big, I'm strong at super middleweight. Inevitably, the time's going to come when I'm going to have to step up to light heavyweight as I get a bit older. But, you know, right now we're making both of these. So, yeah, we can campaign at wherever we want to campaign at.
Okay. Any super middleweight you've got your eye on, or are you just looking at titles?
No names interest me, really. It's just titles. We want meaningful fights and titles. So whoever's got titles or whoever is relevant at this time in my career is who we're after.
How did you guys meet up? Is it because from Wales or, you know, what was the ring?
We both swiped right and he dropped me a little message. He's a long-time friend of my dad. Gavin was training in with Enzo Calzaghe. My dad was back and forth down there when they was all younger, and one thing led to another. And then Gavin stepped in to do my corner later in my amateur career. And went to his gym the following week, and we just clicked ever since. And been cracking on since then.
So you're looking to, what would be your main goal? Would you to bring back boxing big and massive again in Wales? Or yeah, you're just taking a fire
time? That's going to happen with or without me. Boxing's on the up in Wales anyway. But my goal personally is to reach the top, become world champion, retire, be able to live life like how Gavin's living his life, you know, supporting his family and things like that. It's a nice place to be.
Where do you see yourself? Where would you like to see yourself end of 2020 next year?
With a couple of titles, a couple of belts, and pushing on to do big things.
Okay, thanks. Reese, any other fighters you care to talk about?
I got a couple of other fighters, yeah. Craig Evans, fighting British title limited now in a few weeks. I ain't making no comeback, I'm too heavy. Unless I'm going to fight Joe Joy, because no one else wants to box him. yeah, I got a young kid, Jake Tinkin, in Wales. I got a really good gym, full of great amateurs and professionals. So the future's looking bright. Wales boxing's on the up at the moment.
Well, all the best with your future endeavors, and I'll see you guys on Saturday. I'll see you signing out.